Eduardo Diaz. You are the victim's spouse?
Yes. I mean, I was. I'm remarried now.
Well, you may proceed with your statement to the parole board.
First, I want to thank you for this opportunity. I hope you take my appeal to heart. I want to remind the board of the violent nature of the crime Mr. Santos committed. My wife was shot at close range with a .38 caliber pistol. I also want to remind the board that at the time of his trial, Mr. Santos was more concerned about getting a good deal from the DA than he was in expressing a whole lot of remorse. If you grant his parole, he just goes on with his life. 4 years and he just goes on. Ruby Diaz isn't going anywhere. She's in Greenwood Cemetery. Ruby left behind a mom and a dad. Two sisters, five nieces and nephews, funny kids, and a husband. None of us will ever be free of the pain that this man has caused us. We all got life sentences. Parole is supposed to be granted to an inmate who has served his debt to society. As far as I'm concerned, he should be locked up in here for the rest of his life. To let that man out of here now just is not right. It would be an insult to Ruby, and it would be an insult to me and everybody who loved that woman. I guess that's it.
So, if Mr. Santos were granted parole, would you consider him a threat to either you or your family?
No, but that's not the point. The point is that that man shot and killed my wife. And in 4 years, he just walks out of here?
Okay, thank you. Thank you for your statement, Mr. Diaz.
Thank you.
Is there anyone else waiting to make a statement? Bring in Mr. Santos.
I can't stand to look at this guy.
This is your first hearing, is that correct?
Yes, ma'am. Excuse me, but I'd like to say that I'm really sorry about the lady that got shot. You see, I was involved in a scuffle with this other guy when my gun accidentally went off and I killed an innocent bystander. Every day I think about the pain and suffering I caused her and her loved ones. I've written letters to them expressing my remorse. They sent me back the letters unopened.
Well, I see you have trustee status. No disciplinary problems. You earned your GED?
Yes. I'm really proud of that. I also have three college credits. I've been focusing on computer courses for employment purposes. Being incarcerated and being a burden to the taxpayers, you know, things like that, have made me appreciate how important it is for me to give something back to my community, you know? So I contacted several community organizations on the Lower East Side so I can do some volunteer work.
They're gonna let him go. Yeah. You know what? Go home, get Gina and the kids, go out to a movie, dinner, or something like that. Just step away from this.
That's good. Listen, we better get going and beat the traffic.
Okay.
was no way to sugarcoat this, Mrs. Hayes. Because your husband chose not to include you and your son in the witness protection program, he's essentially no longer a part of your life. You will not be told where he has been placed. You may not attempt to contact him. He may not contact you. And if he attempts to do so, he will be jeopardizing his standing in the program and, frankly, putting you in harm's way.
How long will he be gone?
It's open-ended.
While he's in witness protection, can I divorce him?
Take care, Mrs. Hayes.
Thanks.
Good luck.
How'd it go?
She said pretend he got hit by a bus.
How's little Danny taking it?
Well, how much of this can he take? He's 10 years old.
Right. Let's not forget who his mom is and the job you've done with him.
Oh, do you remember his friend, Scott Thompson?
Yeah, Scott Thompson. They were inseparable.
Yes. Well, his mother, Debbie, she's coming to pick me up here, and she wanted to talk to you about a problem that they're having up in Dutchess County. That's where they live now, and if you're too busy, then...
No.
Debbie Thompson's on her way up.
I should have asked you first.
You know what? When she gets here, come in my office.
Are you sure?
That'd be fine.
There she is.
Hey, there she is. Nice to see you again, Debbie.
Well, then you remember me, then.
Of course I remember you. Sit down. How could I forget the mom of Scott Thompson, the Atlantic Beach snow cone consuming champion?
He keeps asking when he's going to see Danny and his cool uncle.
That would be me. How's he doing?
Well, he's kind of sick right now, which is why I wanted to see you. Now I feel really silly. You're here worrying about terrorists and bank robbers, and I'm here about a garbage dump.
It's fine. How can I help?
Well, a bunch of kids at Scott's school have respiratory problems, some rashes, fevers, and we think it's all due to a garbage dump down the road from the school.
They've been to the school board and the health department. You wouldn't believe the runaround that they're getting.
I know this isn't your area, but...
Hold on a second. Joan, call my guy at the EPA and tell him to get right back to me. It's important. Okay? Good. I'm gonna look into this, and you'll have your answer today.
Oh, thanks.
Thanks, Michael.
You okay?
That's a good question.
It's been a long time since you went there.
This isn't about you. I love you.
I know.
I love our babies.
Well, you better. Because we love you.
They just let him go. I want to hurt something.
Let it go.
I get scared, Gina. I get scared.
So Caitlin's friend was right about that dump. The EPA inspectors found standing pools of contaminated water, arsenic and lead, chlorinated metals and solvents were also found at the site in unsealed containers.
Imminent and substantial danger to the health of the community.
Dump site is owned by Wrightwood, Inc.
Who runs Wrightwood?
Thomas Kendall, same Thomas Kendall, who also owns several of the carting companies that use the dump site. I talked to his in-house counsel, Jay Prosser.
Ah, Jay Prosser, well-known defender of scum.
Prosser says that Kendall's not going to talk unless we subpoena him.
Not going to talk? Let's make it simple.
Mr. Kendall, you're under arrest.
What the hell is this?
I'm Michael Hayes. I'm the U.S. attorney.
Hold on. Mr. Hayes, I'm Jay Prosser, Mr. Kendall's attorney.
I know who you are, Mr. Prosser. Your client won't come and see me.
Jay, what the hell is this? What is Mr. Kendall being charged with?
Multiple violations of the Clean Water Act.
Jay, may we have 5 minutes, please?
Take 5 minutes. I'll be outside.
Look, I own 4 different trash hauling companies. I thought we could save some money by consolidating some of the dispatching duties at one location. Bad idea. The chemical waste that was supposed to go to the approved chemical site gets dumped in the wrong place, and then when that site is shut down, some of the drivers don't get word in time.
I find this extremely compelling, Mr. Kendall, but I'm not interested in your excuses.
He's not making excuses. The man is accepting full responsibility. He's rectified the problems, and he's made a generous contribution to the elementary school that was adversely affected.
By adverse effects, I think you mean children coughing up blood. if I'm correct. You know, if he really wants to make a contribution to his community, Mr. Kendall can plead guilty to the charges and save us the cost of the trial.
What if Mr. Kendall were to provide information of great value to your office?
What sort of information?
Mr. Hayes, I think I know what really matters to a United States attorney. And Mr. Kendall has knowledge of a senior government official who has taken bribes on three separate occasions. Now, you came up through public corruption, am I right?
Would you have a name for me?
We need some sort of assurance here.
Your assurance is that you will be able to escort Mr. Kendall here to the arraignment. Thank you, gentlemen.
Mr. Hayes, Tom, look, I think it's time that we have this discussion here. Okay. Mr. Hayes, if you'll close the door, you will get a name.
Sure.
Go ahead, Tom.
It's Vaughn. Your former boss, Bill Vaughn.
I was shocked.
What exactly do you allege Mr. Vaughn to have done?
He took money. You think I'm a crook.
Mr. Kendall's holdings are so wide-ranging, it's inevitable that once in a while, this company or that will become embroiled in some legal entanglement in a U.S. attorney's office.
I paid him, and he made the cases go away.
You paid him?
And he took it.
If these allegations turn out to be false, gentlemen, you both will be in a great deal of pain.
Mr. Kendall will testify for you under oath.
Three cases. June of 94, January and October of 95. You can check them out. I'll give you the company's names.
The sad truth, Mr. Hayes. Your old boss had his hand out.
Come on in. Boy, the juniors look so young. Do you realize that you have AUSAs here younger than my daughter?
I just had kind of a weird thing happen. I'm not sure how to put this.
You don't want me coming down to the office anymore. Understood. Hey, it's your ship now.
No, actually, you've just been named in an active investigation.
In what? By whom?
Because of the uniqueness of the situation,
Feel that... You're going to play it by the book, which is what you should do. Okay, you need to recuse yourself and then talk to Washington about a special prosecutor.
I'm not going to do that yet.
Thank you. I didn't do anything, Michael.
No, I'm certain of that. And I'm sure it'll take me all of an hour and a half to clear this up, and I'm going to do it in-house.
Nothing spurs creativity like a federal indictment. When I took Mickey Dortch down, they said that I fixed the Kentucky Derby.
He seems pretty excited about seeing Scott.
Yeah, he's been talking about it nonstop.
Mom, where's my Quicksilver shirt?
It's in your bottom drawer. And remember to pack a sweater, okay? Because it's supposed to be cold today.
Oh, you know, Debbie was right about the dump.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm glad she told you.
Yeah, so I arrested the guy and, then we closed the place.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so, Uncle Mike's gonna drive you to Scotty's, and if you need me, I'll be home later.
Right.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Have a good day.
Mom, I've been on and over that before.
I know. Have fun. Bye.
Sometimes she thinks I'm six or something.
I know. When was the last time you saw Scott?
I think last summer. What do I say if they ask me about my dad?
If he asks you about your dad, you tell him that your dad is on a secret mission.
Oh, for like the government?
Yeah, like for the government. He's a spy on a secret mission.
It's a good thing I'm used to him being gone, or else I'd really miss him a lot.
Yeah. Okay, let's go.
Here we go. This is Detective Bobby Lloyd from the 2-9, trying to get a number on a parolee named Richie Santos. Nothing on him. We just think he may be able to help us on a case we're working on.
Yeah, I'm looking for Richie Santos. Where is he then? This Ronaldo. You owe him some money. I want to get it to him. a party at the Cheetah Bar. Yeah. Uh-huh. Thank you very much. Now, that'll be it for now. Thanks.
Hey.
Hey.
How'd last night go?
And Gina was tired, so we just stayed in.
You feeling better?
Great. Feel good. Michael, I'm all right.
Good. Glad to hear it. We'll talk later.
Uh-huh.
Hey, Michael.
Kenneth.
How you doing?
How are they treating you at the bureau?
No, fine. Now I finally got my transfer out of bank robbery.
Good for you.
So, you said I might be able to help you with something?
Yeah. We've arrested a man named Thomas Kendall.
Yeah, the big construction guy. God, I investigated a bid rigging scheme once that he was behind. Allegedly. Never went anywhere.
He's made some allegations about a close friend of mine, Bill Vaughn.
Former U.S. attorney?
Yes, know, which is why I would appreciate it if we could keep this unofficial.
What do you need, Michael?
Well, I have my people on it, but I want to take it to a deeper channel.
I can look for connections, phone records, bank statements, wiretap.
That would be very helpful. I want to put this to bed as quickly as possible.
Done. You'll be hearing from me.
Great. Come on in.
Hi. So I took a look at those files that you gave me.
The Kendall files. What was the verdict?
I might have prosecuted, but it could have gone either way.
Okay. On all three?
Yeah, on all three. But it was the same thing. There wasn't really enough evidence.
Okay.
Do I get to know what this is about?
Not yet. But thank you.
Okay.
Good. Thanks for the help. Eddie?
I'm making this my lunch hour.
Little nourishment for the soul.
How'd you find me?
Well, you and I are more alike than maybe you'd care to admit.
If you don't mind, I kind of like to be alone.
I'm starting to get a bad feeling about this. Should I be?
About me coming to church? I'm not allowed to be angry?
Not in our line of work.
I mean, I don't have reason.
Maybe you do, but if you're out of control, I can't use you, and I'm your boss talking to you now.
But you're also my friend. And as my friend, I expect you to understand.
As your friend, I tell you the same thing. You've got to dial this thing way down. I'm gonna head back. You coming?
Now I think I need a little more time.
Okay. Okay. I'll see you back.
I want to thank the state of New York for my all-expense-paid vacation. I really miss this place. I miss you people. And I want to tell you, ladies, okay, but I beat you all back, so watch out.
Hey, Richie. How much did you pay that parole board to let you out? Because my cousin been turned down 4 times.
Well, you know, your cousin was born a criminal, so he ought to be in jail.
Yeah, I've been there, man. You either paid him or you committed some unnatural act.
Hey, if you've been there, then you know what they want to hear, right? So that's what I gave him. Look, I didn't come here to talk to your sorry ass. Where my woman?
Where is she? Where is she?
Where is she?
They got to play them damn cartoons so loud. Turn it down or I'll turn it off.
Eddie, they don't know how to turn it down, and you're scaring them. Sweetheart, you're scaring me, too. Eddie, look at me. Eddie, look at me.
What? What?
What happened to Santos is not right. But what you are doing to this family is not right either.
Gina,
I know, baby. I know. You're right. But Santos walking around out there, I got this rage.
I know, baby, but you gotta let me help you get through this. Don't do this to us.
Santos cut his deal, did his time. Same justice system that I work for. Same justice system that I'm always saying is the best in the world. Rage is still there.
Thanks for coming over in person, Michael.
Well, I wish we could have avoided the whole thing altogether.
Well, you played it right. Long as I've been cleared, who was it that made the charges against me anyway?
Thomas Kendall.
He would.
So you know him?
Yeah, I think he sits on the board of one of Penelope's charities. They'd turn down his money if they could. I mean, such a coarse man. What's he in for?
A number of his companies were investigated between 94 and 96.
He says he paid you off to make the investigations go away.
You ever notice that before? That is a Civil War sword. That is the real thing. 3rd Pennsylvania Cavalry Regiment. I had a great uncle who was a bugler in that brigade. Want to touch it? Come here.
Wow, that's substantial.
I know. Everybody else but me is bored with all this stuff. You should see the expression on Penelope's face when I tell her that we are going to visit another battlefield down south.
How's she doing?
She's up and around, thank you. Say, Michael, can I ask you for a favor?
Sure.
There was a blind item about me in the Post, about my being investigated.
I saw that.
Probably planted by Kendall, no doubt. But the point is that Penelope was upset. So maybe somehow if you could respond.
Well, it's an unofficial investigation.
Roger Quinn covers justice for the Times. Maybe you could talk to him off the record. I'd set it up.
I'll give him a call. Hey.
Hey, man.
How you doing?
I went looking for Santos.
What happened?
I found him. Son of a bitch was celebrating at the Cheetah Bar, 3 blocks from where he shot Ruby.
And you walked away?
Yeah. You know, I've been treating Gina like dirt, ignoring the twins. You ought to get some kind of medal for putting up with me.
Well, you got a family and they depend on you.
And Ruby depended on me too, and I let her down.
How does this honor her memory?
Mind if I take the rest of the day off?
No. No, I think that's a good idea. Go be with your family.
Thanks.
All right?
Yeah, thanks, man.
That A-ball, y'all.
Huh, trying to get me in them like Scotty, huh? Still 20.
No, come on now, man. I can't do that. All I got is a ball.
Man, I ain't got time for it. Get out my face, man. If you ain't got it, man, I got to have 110 at least.
I got a ball, bro.
No, man, ain't enough, man.
I'll tell you what, my homeboy. How about I don't bust your ass?
Oh, my bad, man. Here you go. That's on you. That's on the house.
I love that.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Peace. See ya.
Mr. Hayes. Roger Quinn.
Mr. Quinn. You know what, let's step over here, if you don't mind. Excuse me. I'm going to cut right to the chase with you, Mr. Quinn. I'm not real big on off-the-record conversations. Bill Vaughn has been the victim of unsubstantiated rumors in the press.
What are you drinking?
I'm not. These rumors...
I like Bill. Yes, and I think the Post ran a story and The Voice.
Yes, but he is not the subject of an inquiry. Now, my office has investigated the allegations against him. They are unfounded.
Are you referring to Thomas Kendall's allegations that Vaughn took money to drop cases?
That's classified.
When we read these items in the other papers, we put a couple of people on the story, you know, to check up on the Vaughn-Kendall connection.
As did we.
We put our people in the street. Are you aware that as recently as 8 months ago, Vaughn and Kendall were seen entering a building where Kendall owns a condo, supposedly keeps a mistress there, Terry something.
I'll notify the Attorney General.
Look, the cases you investigated were years ago, right? So what's Vaughn doing with Kendall last summer?
Mr. Quinn, it is not a crime to enter a building.
Bottom line, we're going with the story. It's on 3rd Avenue. Here's the address.
Terry Putnam?
Yeah, I'm Terry. Tom, meeting you here?
Not exactly.
So, who the hell are you?
My name is Michael Hayes. I'm the U.S. attorney, and I'm investigating Tom Kendall.
Then you can leave right now, because I have nothing to say.
All right, then I'll subpoena you, and we can do this in my office.
Look, I'm not exactly crazy about Tom myself, but he has a family. I mean, why destroy him? Because he has a boyfriend.
I'm not... frankly, interested in his personal life. I'm interested in the business dealings that go on in this apartment. Are you involved in them?
No, I'm not.
No. Okay, well, if that's true, then you've got nothing to worry about. If I find out you're lying and it impedes my investigation, I'm going to come back here, Mr. Putnam.
Look, if I tell you... I told Tom I didn't want to have anything to do with it. This is his place. He pays for it. I mean, it's not like I had a choice. Tom gave people money. And then I would bill one of his companies for the same amount using these invoices.
Cutting edge graphic design.
Yeah, I came up with that.
Is this a real company?
No, but I took night courses. I could have done it. I tend bar, okay? He pays the bills. You know what a place like this rents for?
Have you seen this man before? I'm going to order a special prosecutor, Bill.
I thought that was all taken care of.
I've just come from Terry Putnam's.
Kendall's lover.
You know him, too.
If I knew about it and didn't say anything, it's because I'm a gentleman. Are you going to ruin my reputation based on something a little gold digger like Terry Putnam says?
Did you take money from Kendall?
Absolutely not. You know, Michael, I thought giving you this job might enlighten you. Apparently, it hasn't. I gave you your damn job, Michael.
And you taught me how to do it, Bill. Excuse me. Yeah. Hey, what's the matter? I know Gina, I haven't seen him. Let me look around, and I'll get back to you. Okay, hang in there.
I'm retired, Michael. I don't have any power. I mean, if something happened, it's over.
I'm sorry, Bill. Call your lawyer.
Yo, listen, hurry up, man, before I get back.
Yeah, it's police. Yeah, I'm calling from the Cheetah Bar over here on 12th. And they got some serious crack dealing going on up in here. Oh, yeah, they're messing up the room for everybody. Yeah. I got a look at one of them, a real good look. Puerto Rican dude, about 5'8", a goatee, a black suede jacket, like some beige in it. I heard someone call him Santos. Yeah, and they got guns up in there, too. Glad to be of help. Yeah, sounds good, thank you.
Bad Richie Santos.
Yo, man, how are you?
You ain't going nowhere.
Yo, bro. What do you want, money? Bro, there you go. You got it, man. You got it. Come on, man. That's all I got, man. Come on, man. That's all I got, man. I swear.
You remember her?
Bro, please.
Do you remember?
Bro, if that's your old lady I'm sitting on, man, come on, I'm sorry, man. I apologize. Come on, man.
Shut up. You killed her. That's my wife. You remember now? Do you remember?
Yeah, I remember, man. What do you want, man? Come on.
I want to send you to hell.
Bro, I'm trying to do good with my life, man.
You did 4 years! My wife's life is worth more than 4 years.
Come on, man. I'm trying to do good with my life, man. Bro, every day I have to go.
Shut up! Get up! Get your ass up. Get over here. Empty your pockets. Empty your pockets.
All right.
Your coat pockets. Your coat pockets!
Bro, that's not mine, man. Take that, man. You can have it.
Watch your ass.
Okay.
Watch your ass.
Watch your ass.
What are you doing, Eddie?
Yeah, my bad. Just a misunderstanding. But you better stay away from here.
Right.
Let's go. Well, I guess you're gonna do whatever you want to do.
I had to look him in his face and know that I can be in the same room, in the same world with him and not kill him. And I did it. See, I got to live my life too, Michael.
Hi, Michael. It's Bill Vaughn. I need to talk to. I don't feel very good. I have to see you right away. Give me a call. Thanks.
You sure this is an emergency? Mr. Vaughn usually doesn't get up this early.
Open the door, please.
Pennsylvania Cavalry. They won and they lost. But when they went out, it was in a red blaze.
Did you take these?
Makes the most sense. Don't you think? I don't know why, Michael. I swear to God, I don't know why, but I thought that one day something big was gonna happen. Something that was gonna make my life, I don't know, important.
Bill, did you take these?
I couldn't. I'm too much of a coward. Don't let it happen to you, Michael. You won't be the promising young man forever.
Let's sit down and work it out.
Don't you tell me what to do!
Then you tell me.
I'll go in with you.
You're making the right decision.
You respected me.
Of course I did. I do. And nothing is going to change that, Bill.
So, can you help me out here, Michael? Michael.
Stop by.
Yeah, I guess I was wondering if you guys were holding up okay.
We're holding up real well.
Good.
Sit down.
Right.
You spent so much time worrying about me and Danny Jr., I worry about you too.
I don't think you should put a whole lot of energy into that.
Well, I do.
You know, aside from the fact that I drive people to prison or suicide or both, people that I love, I can't have a personal relationship. And my own brother is in the witness protection program because of a sting that I put him into. I mean, aside from those things, I'm fine. And now...